You know, it's going to be a great day because I've come to visit a very famous name, Dormobile, a company that's still going decades later, and they still make the canopies in the original way that they did back in the day. Hello!
Hey, Mike.
And how you doing?
Good to see you.
And you,
thanks,
mate.
Thanks so much for coming down.
Do you know what? It was one of those days where it was like, I'm going to go to Dormobile. You know, I was born into a period when you referred to a camper van as a Dormobile.
That's right. Nobody said camper van. Nobody said motorhome. They didn't use those terms.
No.
They would use the term Dormobile. Exactly. And you could go to any campsite in the 60s, late 50s, and you would see Dormobile everywhere, loud, proud, in your face.
Fantastic.
And here we are.
So this caught my eye behind me. An original Dormobile?
It's an original Dormobile. It's a Ford Transit Custom Mark 1, 1969. And it's a beaut.
I love the colour, by the way.
Glad you say that.
My Bedford CA is hand-painted dark green over a sort of lighter, creamy colour.
Ooh, okay.
Yeah, it's a little bit sore, but this reminds me of the seaside and holidays.
Doesn't it?
Is the colour it should be, I think.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Can I open it up?
Of course you can.
Yeah?
Please do.
You're going to love this. It's a sense of theatre when you open these up. It's lovely. Because the step, look at that, comes out to greet you.
It's all about design and innovation of its time. The 50s and 60s, the Dormatic seat, a seat that folds down into a bed, was wow.
Good. I sent you some pictures along of my vehicle. Did you discover anything?
It looks fantastic, first off, but I noticed the build plate, for example. It's an original Dormobile build plate. What I can tell you about that is, in 1959, the factory in Luton had a dedicated train line that went from Luton to Folkestone to the Martin Walter factory, you would have had thousands of Bedford CAs coming out of Luton, straight into Folkestone, into the factory, conversion, registered, build plate, done.
So mine's not a van that somebody bought and converted after. This is off the production line. Oh, brand 100%. New, straight into the factory, turned into a brand new Dormobile.
100%. We've got an original brochure.
Do you know, these are the good bits. I love these
bits. These are the good bits, aren't they? If you look at some of these old images,
they're great,
I just
aren't
love
they?
Them. Yeah.
They're great. The family all crammed in the back.
So this is actually the first time that we see the Dormobile name being used. That's the headline, perhaps. £545.
£545. Complete. Pounds.
I know. I'll take two, please.
Yeah, please. That's how much they were. Yeah. And so my vehicle is...
So this is it here.
So I've kind of got a good one, haven't I?
You've got a good one.
If we go that colour, I want this red and white.
The red and white candy stripe canopy, which is, that's Dormobile, essentially.
And you supply that here?
Absolutely.
Can I see the workshop?
This is the place to see that.
Yeah, lovely. Let's go. This
is where the magic happens.
This is my kind of place. I love it. Look at this workshop.
So, honestly, at the moment, it's so varied. We've got all sorts going on.
Look at the Type 2.
I know,
fantastic.
Right? So, this is a split screen. It actually had a different pop top on it. And we've cut a bigger hole and we're bringing it into the Dormobile family.
I just love it.
Right, okay. Well, let's hand over your canopy.
Wonderful. Look at this lot.
I know. So, look, you're going to need that. That's the instructions.
What, it doesn't come pre-drilled?
No, no, those are the ties as well to fit to the hoops. We're here to support you. You give us a call anytime.
Okay, okay, that's brilliant.
So this is yours. Essentially, it's the same as that. It's just wrapped the other way around.
Which is going to look the same as that, isn't it?
Correct. That's it. It's going to look superb. Red and white candy stripe canopy on your Bedford. Perfect.
Lovely. Well, listen, thank you so much for today. It's
pleasure.
Been a real inspiration. I've definitely got some great ideas, and it's great to see Dormobile flourishing still. It really is.
Good. Thanks
Fantastic.
So much for coming.
And I've got another Dormobile to put on the road.
There you go.
Thanks, Ant.
Cheers.
See you later.
See you later.
That was a success. Not only have I come away with a new canopy, but I've also got the colour scheme for Colin. Best call Elvis and let him know.
We're nearly ready for the one thing that actually brought Colin and I down to Derek's in the first place. Getting it painted. You nearly done, Derek?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. I know how you feel. Should we get it out and into the paint booth?
Yeah, it's good.
In preparation, Colin has been sanded down to smooth out any imperfections, creating a nice, even surface ready for the new paintwork. Oh, mate. Well, I'm knackered. This is your bit, so whilst you go and get on with that, I'm going to go and have a sit down.
On your bike, you've got to mask this lot up yet.
Well, that's me told.
As I'm masking up the trims, Derek cracks on with putting on a primer paint to provide a uniformed surface for our coloured paint to stick to. Covering Colin in primer, paint and lacquer is a massively time-consuming job, and I just hope it doesn't take us too many days to get our dormer picture perfect for that all-important summer ad.
I'm Mike. So nice to meet you. Oh!
It's been a race against time.
I think we've got to get Colin the camper ready for summer.
Oh, you're talking about next summer, right?
No.
To rescue and revive Colin the camper.
We've still got to fit a new engine and gearbox and give Colin that full respray.
As we tackled our trickiest ever engine...
Oh, that's such a relief. It actually fits in the hole.
..and interior upgrade.
Measure twice, cut once.
After a few final days at Derek's finishing the paintwork, it's time to get back to Mike for the last job of fitting the interior.
No way! Get out of here! Seriously! Is that our Colin?
It's amazing, isn't it?
That is fantastic. What a transformation. I said to you, give me the taste of summer, but you've actually... bottled summer and you put it inside a vehicle. That's incredible. That colour is so strong.
Well, your trip down to Dormobile was the full inspiration for this, and I think it's just worked out perfectly, honestly. It's amazing.
And so what about the engine, that Pinto I got you?
You're going to love this, mate, because it's in there. Look at that.
Oh, mate.
I mean, it took a load of shoehorning it in, a bit of mods to the chassis and to the bodywork, but it's in there. And, of course, the auto gearbox, and you'll like this. I've kept hold of the original column shifter.
Colin shifter. That is fantastic. I love it. I've never been happier to see a vehicle. Colin is looking unbelievable, mate. Well done.
And I tell you what, this is my handiwork, but I also know you've been busy, so do you want to show me what you've been up to?
I've done nothing.
No, come on, I can see it. Come and show me.
Yeah,
come on.
You ready?
Let's have a look.
Ta-da!
Oh, my God, have you done that yourself?
My O-level... woodwork came back and I just remembered how to do things. And I've built quite a bit of furniture in the past. And do you know what I'm going to say? I really enjoyed it. It was really pleasurable.
Mate, they're amazing. That looks good. So good. You did the seats as well and curtains.
I'd like to take the credit for those, but actually I didn't know. I farmed that work out to somebody else and I think they've done an amazing job. And what with the colour combination, with the seats, the curtains and the cupboards, and what you've done with Colin, it's going to look amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, so different to when you drop that van off.
All we've got to do is fit it. Straight in?
Well, hang on. There's one new bit of Colin that you haven't seen fitted yet.
What are we doing?
Pop that down there. Hold on.
Oh, yeah. Oh, mate, that's amazing! That ties the whole thing together. I am so pleased with the way that's turned out.
Looks good, doesn't it?
It does, right. We're going to have to get all this stuff loaded in as quickly as we can because I need to get pictures of it and get it up there online.
All right. Going that way, isn't it?
We wanted to reinvigorate our Colin, but is there enough life left in our Bedford for it to holiday once more? We paid just $4,500 for Colin. Engine and automatic gearbox, £1,000. Rear axle and prop shaft, £220. Reupholstery of the seats, £1,000. Interior fixtures and fittings, £1,067. Canopy and roof upgrades, £395. Paintwork, £2,000. That's a transformative total of £10,182.
Well, I'm going to tell you, it smells absolutely delicious in it. It really does.
It does from out here.
So, one sausage or two?
Definitely two.
I've got a funny feeling we've nailed this. What with the retro styling? But we've sort of updated it at the same time.
Yeah, yeah, you've done a cracking job, honestly. You've smashed it inside there. And this cabinetry as well. Amazing. And you've tied in the colour scheme, the flooring, the roof, the... I mean, even the kettle. Look at that colour code. It's all about those details, isn't it?
Shall we get outside and enjoy the great outdoors?
Definitely. Nice job there, mate.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
A little bit of a chef, I can do that, especially in the back of Colin. Oh, I'm looking forward to this.
I feel like I've spent a lot of nights with Colin, but what a great spot to spend our last night with him.
It's wonderful, isn't it? And this is all the rage, isn't it? People do want to go out and enjoy the great outdoors.
Click here to subscribe.